got a workout vault, and I just want to remind everybody to make sure that you get some kind of supervision, especially at first when you're trying these exercises, maybe with a teacher or another dancer or even a Pilates instructor, especially like Diarra.
I'm going to start area turned out, so the calves are hugging the sides of the wall. This is just a basic bridge, right? So it's just going to start to articulate through the spine, rolling up, the legs are going to extend long through here, but then we're just spotting where the pelvis stays leveled. And she's going to bend her knees, roll the spine back down. She wants to hug the wall in toward the tailbone, right? Good. So starting from the base of the spine, just articulating through. Good. Nice long knees and long toes here. Good. And then breathing out slowly, round the spine back down. Ball comes back in toward the tailbone.
Oh my goodness, I feel that already, like on my back and in my abdominals, my low abdominals especially, which kind of, if you end up having to sit a lot or teach a lot, your low abs kind of get disengaged, and I can really feel that, especially the back of the legs.
The back of the legs is really what this exercise is targeting. Yeah. So Mary, since you're a little hyperextended in the knee, we can get the ball a little more underneath the knees, right? And we're going to roll up into that bridge with the hips externally rotated, good. And then we're going to flex the feet from here, good. We're going to internally rotate, good. And then we're going to point the feet, good. We're going to externally rotate, and then flex the feet, right? And then you just repeat that, turn in, good, point the feet, and then turning out. And we're going to reverse that direction, so turning in from here, and then we'll flex, and then we'll turn out, and then we'll point, we'll repeat that pattern.
Just watching
for Mary's pelvis to stay nice and steady. We're also making sure that the ball is still underneath her knees here. Point.
And would you rest in between these sets?
So you can absolutely rest in between sets. The goal is really to be able to sustain the bridge and to do that sequence without dropping the hips back down. And that just takes some practice. Exactly. This is really looking very nice. We're also making sure that Mary's not dropping into her lower back, right? So we don't want to hyperextend the lumbar spine.
Right, so that would be
incorrect, right? So we want to make sure that the front ribs are nice and soft and the lower back is in a neutral position.
Goodness. Oh my goodness. Woo!
And it doesn't take many reps for that to really start to burn.
Oh.
Good, go ahead and release from there.
So for this one, we need a small ball.
We need
right?
a smaller ball. Okay. So I'm going to have you lay on your side. Right? Good. And you can prop your head up. And if it's more comfortable to recline, you can also extend that arm. So I'm going to have Mary externally rotate. We're going to start with the ball at mid-calf, right? And we're going to make sure that we're rolling right on top of that supporting thigh. And also spotting the top hip, making sure that this is to the back. And Mary's going to start a double peg, so she's going to bend this knee, dragging the ball up toward her tailbone. She's going to grab the ball with her free hand, and she's going to extend that leg until we develop an opposite on. Good. Right? And then we're going to bend the knee, bring the toes back down to the ball. Good. And you're going to slowly lengthen all the way back down. And we'll take another repetition here. So develop a. Good. And catch the ball, and then lengthen up, but just making sure that that top leg is stacked. Nice. And then we're going to bend the knee. Good. A little pressure into the ball as you extend, right?
Ooh,
good.
Oh.
Right? And you notice that it's going to cause some instability in the
ball.
So try one more, right? So develop okay here.
If anybody's watching this, just know that it's really going to work out your turnout, your extension, works your core, and also I tried to cheat a little bit and I fell over.
And
so,
fell over.
Yeah.
So the ball does not lie, right? It will definitely, it's a bit of an oracle.
Let's see, can I try one more?
So yeah, there's a couple of variations. We can go ahead and develop it here, right? And then we can do a Ranjan on layer. So we can just take a little bend here. We can do that. Or you can bend the knee out. That's your Ranjan. Right? You can reverse that. Exactly. Good. You can bring the toe back onto the ball and then extend away.
And then you did a more advanced version where you go up.
Yeah, so if the turnout is available, you can place your foot in this position. We'll call that on the walk, right? And then go ahead and try it from here. So this is just a little bit more difficult. It challenges the stability of the pelvis and the strength of your turnout muscles here. Nice, Mary. Good. And extend all the way back down. Beautiful.
Oh, I totally feel that. That was amazing.
Yeah.
Thank you so
much.
Make
sure you do both sides so you're not in
it. Yeah. Okay, so those exercises were amazing, and actually Diarra's going to show us a few more. She's going to demonstrate. of DR. Thank you so much. I really feel my turnout and my abdominals right now, so I know everybody else will like them very much. And can you tell everybody how they can find you?
You can find me on Instagram and Facebook at Snatched Fitness NYC.
Okay, we'll also throw that up on screen as well. And I just want to take a moment to thank everybody for watching. Click if you like something. Don't forget to subscribe. And thanks for watching.